With a normal swallow, food and liquids move from the mouth into the esophagus directed by a precise sequence of coordinated muscle movements. When a swallow is initiated, the epiglottis flips down, protecting the airway. The cricopharyngeus muscle, or upper esophageal sphincter, relaxes and opens to allow food and liquids to pass into the esophagus. Afterwards, the cricopharyngeus muscle closes back up to prevent any regurgitation back up into the throat. The esophageal muscle then contracts and relaxes in a wave-like movement that propels food and liquids down into the stomach. This movement is called peristalsis. Trouble swallowing, also known as dysphagia, can be described in many different ways. However, the simplest way of thinking about swallowing problems is whether it is a physical or a functional problem. A physical problem is due to any type of physical obstruction, whether it be large tonsils, a stricture, or even a cancerous tumor. Typically, patients with a physical obstruction have no problem swallowing liquids unless the obstruction is severe, but do have issues with swallowing solids. Compared to liquids, this difficulty is because solid foods cannot pass as easily around an obstruction, causing things to catch or even get stuck. Most other swallowing complaints are due to functional deficits rather than a physical obstruction. The cricopharyngeus muscle may not open in time during a swallow, causing liquids to potentially aspirate into the airway. Solid food swallows may be fine since solids move more slowly compared with liquids. Treatment is typically to thicken any liquids to slow its movement, making it easier to swallow. Alternatively, the cricopharyngeus muscle opens on time but does not open as much as it should. Because the opening is tighter than normal, solid foods and pills often hang up in the throat, causing occasional choking episodes. Liquids, however, can pass through just fine even though the opening is smaller than normal. Treatment is to thoroughly chew smaller chunks of solids before swallowing or to eat only pureed solids. Of course, it's not just the cricopharyngeus muscle that may not work properly, but also the esophageal muscles. Instead of a smooth wave-like contraction and relaxation to propel food consistently downward, it may be uncoordinated or even absent, causing solid foods to move up and down with even some hesitations. Liquid swallows are typically unaffected since they are not as influenced by such dysmotility and/or aperistalsis. Finally, a patient may suffer from one or more of these issues, causing significant swallowing difficulties. Keep in mind that the swallowing issues described here are only general principles and that there are many other forms of dysphagia and treatments.